This video I want to talk about backing up your WordPress database, and to do that we're going to use a plugin, and the plugin we're going to use is called the WordPress database backup plugin, and it's by this guy here, Austin Matsko, if I pronounce that correctly. Now when you're searching for the plugins you will find lots of database backup plugins. Make sure you select this one. Now once you've installed the plugin and activated the plugin, then we need to configure it, and we do this at in the tools in the backup here. Now it's split into sections. The first section is a general section and you don't have to change. It's going to back up these tables. These are the core WordPress tables. And then we've got another section here. This is for a manual backup. Now you can have lots of additional tables, and when you install extra plugins you'll find those plugins, or some of those plugins, add to the database. And so it's important that you actually go back and look at your backup configuration periodically, especially when you've added plugins. Now the first section here, the second section really, deals with the manual backup, which comes here next in the third section. So if you're doing a manual backup, you can save it to the server, you can download it to your computer, or you can have it emailed to you. I tend to, with manual backups, I tend to download them to the computer. Having said that, I very rarely do manual backups. Now, and if you want to do a manual backup, I recommend you always select, as no matter what type of backup, you always select all of the tables. There's no point actually worrying about whether you need them or not. Just select all of them. And to do that, you click the first one and hold the shift key and click the last one. And you can see they're all checked. Now, so that's the manual backup. If you go further down, the schedule backup. Now, this is what I recommend you do. I schedule mine once weekly. The screenshot you're actually seeing is actually one of my live sites. I came to this one because you can actually see there's lots of extra tables here. Now again, make sure they're all selected, and again you can use the shift key to do that. And once weekly is usually enough, and you configure an email address to have an email to. You can change the schedule time if you want to by clicking this. There's nothing to click to save any of those settings, so that it's already set. So if yours aren't ticked, make sure they're ticked. Make sure you've got a valid email address, and then select your schedule. Okay, that's it. Quite simple. You should always be creating a backup, whether you're doing a manual backup or a scheduled backup, which I recommend, because manual backups you can easily forget. Don't rely on your host to be backing up your WordPress installation. So that's the end of this video. Until the next video, bye.